Okay, so you can see that the plunger will slip to one side, that's the north side there, and what it'll do is it'll push the plunger down forward like that. Because of this rounded inside edge, the plunger end slips to one side and falls down that like a crevice there, and that'll go down and all the silicone will come up the side. So what we've got to do is get a grinder, small grinder, and grind out this lip folding over and in toward the middle there. Yeah, so what I'll be doing is I'll be getting my grinder, my Dremel, and just grinding out this lip that curls inside. As I said, the plunger sits over, it's drawn into, it falls down in one side down there, and pushes this over. Yeah, so this is the type of thing that I'm using. Just got a long extension, and the grinder's on the tip there. As you can see there, the plunger is sitting in its guide well and truly, and you know, it's perfect like that. Okay, success. I've just mended this car seat cover, and as you can see, the plunger's gone down and there's no silicone around the back there. So that's a fix. If you don't do this modification to the Selly's tube, then this is what's going to happen.
There's the silicone. Okay, so I'll try and get that out of there. And it's not going to release because it'll be hooked in behind the plastic, piece of plastic in there. But I'm putting a lot of stress on that. I can't get the plunger out. Okay. There's the evidence right there. That's the plunger that goes down. It's supposed to come out there. Okay, there we go. There, that's your plunger. See how the inside of it's curled around? So